Greetings to all you viewers out there in internet land watching us on your magic box. This is the Stopclick. I'm Raven.
I'm MJ.
We have an awesome show for you tonight.
But first, some solemn news. John Keys is no longer with us.
Yeah, he is taking a break.
For no, Raven. No, he's gone. He's gone, Raven. We need to move on.
He'll be back.
No, Raven. He's dead. He's gone forever.
John Keys isn't dead.
Raven, do you remember when sweet baby Asian John Keys come to the top of the water and you go, bah, bah, bah. Do you remember, Raven?
That definitely was your pet goldfish.
No, Raven. Do you remember he'd be like, we few, we happy few, we band of brothers. Do you remember that, Raven? Do you remember that?
He definitely Henry V. You're quoting Shakespeare.
No, Raven. No, remember he would swim down and grab the clam. And he'd swim up to the rock and he'd hit the clam against the rock and eat the sweet, delicious clam meat and play with all the other sea otters and hold hands.
You are definitely talking about a sea otter you saw at the zoo.
No, Raven, he's gone forever. He's gone. He's gone. No, oh, I miss him so much. Raven, do you remember him?
No.
Roll the montage.
Wait, do you mean the Sarah McLachlan montage or the John Denver montage?
Which one is the one with the pets that are sad?
Oh, that's the Sarah McLachlan.
Sarah McLachlan.
What montage?
I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by.
In the blazing Blue Beetles britches was that?
It's a beautiful montage for John Keys.
That wasn't a montage. That was a goldfish, Henry V, and a sea otter.
That was John Keys, right?
I want to adopt a sea otter now because of this.
I know, he's beautiful, wasn't he?
He's not, like, I'm talking to him on Facebook. He's not dead.
That's the ghost of John Keys on Facebook. This is the ghost of John Keys on Facebook.
All right, well, either way, can we just get on with the show?
Okay, that's fine.
All right, so, in this awesome show, where, low point figures, what happened?
What happened to low point figures?
Well, when the game first started, there was a bunch of really awesome low point figures.
So if we go back to the heydays, the early days, the darker days.
The
golden age days, there you go, of HeroClix. We have, obviously, the veteran, you have the rookie, you have the experienced system where you had multiple dials, and they were all different, and you could get the same character multiple times. You had the blue, you get gold.
Fun fact about that.
Dropping it.
Fun fact about that. That system is still in effect, actually. If you pay attention to characters with multiple starting points, you'll see their colors, yellow, red and blue.
Yeah.
Rookie, experienced, veteran, and stuff like that. So it's still in there, but they're just not reprinting the
figures. Sure. And then I'll be honest, and there used to be, like, from what I remember, like hundreds of figures. There were
hundreds, yeah.
Like, I mean, you'd actually
have to buy. There's literally three versions of every character.
Yeah, most of the time. Yeah, most of the time. But obviously they moved away from that. But back then, you would actually get smaller point values. Even then, I do agree, in recent years, they've tried to make the game, I think it's a hazard of making the game not quite so long. When you had a bunch of pieces and a limited action pool for 300 points, you had five or six figures that all couldn't do anything in a turn. Like, you couldn't have everybody do something in a turn.
Here's my issue with that, too, is
team abilities were fixing it?
Well, like, back then, it made a use for the Avengers team ability.
Yeah. Nowadays, it almost...
There's no reason to have an Avenger team ability anymore.
Because you can't possibly run that many Avengers
exactly.
To make up the points. Yeah.
And so, I mean, I understand they changed it, but why don't they fix the team abilities or something that we're so dependent on that?
Well, I'll be honest. We're not, like, dependent. And I'll be honest. Right, these days, what you'll see occasionally, and it is once in a blue moon, is someone with a full Avengers team moving one Avenger and three making the attack per turn and kind of advancing, kind of bringing them back. And but you're right, it doesn't have the same effect like it used to. Nowadays, you see Mystics, and I'll be honest, that was, you know, Mystics is still a very powerful team ability, and it didn't really lose its luster. But if you'll remember, a lot of these old things, for their point values, had huge dials, ridiculously long dials, like 8 clicks, and they go to like 14 defense, but you'd see attacks of 8.
There was Nightmare. The guy from ASM, right, was sitting on the...
The Bone Throne.
Yeah. His original click had 14 attack. He was 180-something points.
That's ridiculous.
14 attack.
Yeah, which, I mean, like, it's better than Hyperion Prime, you know, which is a 275-point or 10-point figure.
Exactly. Yeah. And of course, he tanked. He was, like, at, a, like, 13 defense by the end of it, but still.
Yeah,
like,
there was a steeper fall-off, too. Yeah. And but I'll be honest. I think what... Like I said, once again, I think that's a consequence of trying to make your games fit into a 45-50 minute time frame, because when you have figures that at least for the meta stuff, when you have figures that are 100 points, they're easy to build around. You get your super solid 100 100 100 or 50 50 100 100, or some variant.
Yeah, it's very it fits really well.
You know, and I'll be honest, you don't see, you see less and less figures with really odd point values. I mean, you still see your Brother Voodoo or Captain Marvel Prime.
Yeah.
See 82 points and 79 points. But you also, you see a whole lot of 50, 100-point pieces. There's just a lot of them now.
Yeah.
And I'll be honest, I think the Flash is probably the least guilty of the recent sets of doing that particular problem. But, you know, Slosh had 200-point Grundy, had 100-point, 175-point Superboy. You had all these Bizarro 25 points each Orab you put on him. So there were these nice little cookie cutters that made you feel like you got the most out of your team. Because it is kind of frustrating to go, well, that's 278 and nothing costs 22 points that I have. So
you know what made me laugh? There's a Howard the Duck piece. It's 43 points. It has leadership.
What does that even do?
Right? Like, are you kidding me? Like,
he's
like,
gonna,
that will attest to how low most of these figures were used to be.
Yeah.
Because a Howard the Duck with leadership at 43 points.
So in the last, 3 years, what do you think were the biggest low point pieces that we've seen?
Oh, biggest low. Last 3
like,
years.
Like, okay, yeah, last three. Like the last 3 years of modern age, what do you think were the, I mean.
Enchantress was a big one.
I think she didn't see as much play as the Chaos Force Scarlet Witch.
You want to talk about value town.
They ran two of her in some teams. Like, that's how meta she was.
Yeah, that's like getting a Big Mac from McDonald's and there's like a third patty in there.
Yeah, that's a bonus.
Instead of the piece of bread in the middle, third patty. Yeah. And you know what? They're going to throw another slice of cheese on that.
Just
maybe some bacon,
maybe
too.
The next super value piece that comes out, I want it referred to as the third patty.
The third patty.
I'm telling you, this thing had everything.
But no, she Perplex, Prob, and Mystics. I mean, I'll be honest, there was not really a whole lot you couldn't get done with that. You know, that was extremely good.
Yeah.
And I'll be honest, that's why she, during her meta time, was a $50 piece, and she came in a Fast Forces set that cost less than that. MSRP. Yeah. Like, yep. So her value exceeded the Fast Forces set by such a huge margin. I mean, that was, you know, that's how important she was to the meta at the time. But, I mean, and I'll be honest, I think the Flash has a couple of breakout pieces for Modern.
Yeah.
I think we even saw in one of the recent ROCs, the Star Labs Technician.
Yes.
Which is a 33-point TKer, which we love. We love 33-point TKers. Has the give a power action.
Yeah, from toughness, so precision strike.
Precision strike on for the turn, which is very nice. Precision strike doesn't
I actually died from a Destiny with precision strike.
That's awesome.
Like, she took out Kyle Rayner.
That's funny. Well, that's all you need.
It's just like, don't underestimate precision strike.
Yeah, well, and I'll be honest, with super senses floating around as much as it does.
Oh, another good low value piece too is Weasel.
Weasel
enhancement and the plus one to their attack.
Yeah, and then the really thing that's prob but not prob if they miss by one. That's I'll be honest, Weasel I've seen a lot recently.
Yeah.
Not nearly as effective with other pieces, but not somebody you can ignore either.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I really like. As far as he's not quite a low point piece, I really think we haven't quite seen enough of Rainbow Raider. I know he's kind of a joke piece because he does ride a rainbow,
and his whole dial is a rainbow,
and it I'll be honest, it's a little campy, but old Flash villains always were. But his ability to say -1 all combat values to anybody. Yeah. When you give him a power action to anybody on their entire team.
Give him a power action, pick a color. Anybody on your opponent's team that has that color and their powers get -1 to all their combat values.
All combat values, like a super perplex. And it doesn't fall off.
Yeah, it does not fall off.
It only goes away until he chooses again.
Yeah.
And so the whole game, you can do this just one time and completely hose a lot of different characters. Like, what makes me terrified is, like, Engineer, I think she has whole dial toughness. And that's, you just go orange, great. She, for the whole game, is -1 for all her combat values.
And you can't pick white, or black.
You can't pick white or black. Yeah, you can't pick. You know, you only pick colors of the rainbow. Roy G. Biv. You only pick colors of the rainbow. But I'll be honest. I think that's right in the range of kind of a low point support piece. He's got a good solid dial. Got a lot of clicks. A lot of powers that don't really interact with each other. That kind of happens just by its given nature of, I have Blades, Claws, Fangs, Super Senses, and Stealth. You're not really getting a whole lot done with that particular piece at that particular time.
Yeah.
But I think it's promising. I think he can be a promising piece. I know we've talked about Weasel. We've talked about the Star Labs tech. I miss Enchantress. I do. I also miss John Constantine. I'll mention it every show until the show goes off the air. I miss John Constantine. That was my saying no to Prob. Is I want a shirt with just a picture of John Constantine that says "Say No to Prob." And that's all it does. Is you just completely
almost as much as you miss John Keys.
John Keys. I miss John Keys. Sweet baby angel, John Keys.
Blah blah.
You remember that? You know, you remember that now, when he comes to the top of the water and he go bah bah
bah. A bunch of the sheep.
And we feed him little fish flakes. You remember that?
No. No, I don't.
I remember that so well.
But, anyway. Yeah, and I remember just. Distinctly remember actually getting dominated when I first started playing by the Shield team.
Oh yeah,
low point figures.
Oh yeah,
they run all these Shield agents, the Shield medic, all this stuff, and they run one temp pole.
Well, one guy making huge ranges for attack,
and that was disgusting. Oh,
yeah,
man.
I'll be honest. I think the team that really brought that team ability into just kind of overpowered land was the Cat Black Widow duo from, that's not that old, from Winter Soldier, but that was 130 points of duo attack with precision strike, and they didn't activate damage depletion on it.
Yeah, the Avengers initiative, so they ignore hindering.
Ignore hindering, and they also could shoot at like 12 range, and you're like, I can't not be near these. Oh, they had sidestep too.
Yeah.
So you were never really out of range of that team, and that was just like you were not comfortable trying to move in on them at all. Like there was almost no way for you to get the first hit in.
Yeah.
And I'll be honest, that was due to the fact that that Shield team worked really, really well together. And you had Maria Hill back there,
the Shield agents.
Yeah, Shield agents. Oh. And you had Maria Hill going, well, outwit from across the map with a power action, outwit your invulnerability or invincible or whatever. Great, here I come. You know, there we go. And then you just get completely destroyed by it. But
yep.
I'll be honest, I don't think we see too much of that in the meta, mostly because of the Kyle Rayners and the zombie super scroll stuff like that. But you're right, there has been a distinct lack of. I mean, we're getting better, I think, going back to the smaller point pieces that can have effect on the game. But I think the days of
massive
20. I'll be honest, like Plastic Man, not Plastic Man, Elastic Man.
Yeah. Flatman.
Flatman. There we go. Sorry, but once again, a bunch of different superheroes I just named. But they're all superheroes. Elongated Man, Plastic Man. You know, everybody's a winner.
Flatman.
Duckman. I don't know. There's all sorts of ones. Animal Man. Anyway, new con exclusive, by the way. But the Flatman was the 28 points, and he was just he was plasticity, and he was just an amazing tie-up piece. That was all he really did was tie people up. And he actually was okay at it. Like, I don't think he ever saw a lot of meta play, but in a game where you just needed somebody to hold back or hold the line on a doorway where you didn't really want a speedster to come around, he served his purpose well. So I think you occasionally get a gem every so often, but not like it used to be. You are correct. There are very few low point playable.
I don't think there's a chance in the world we'll see another Fast Forces Scarlet Witch. Not Scarlet Witch yourself,
but a piece that makes that much effect on the meta. You're probably right about that.
Yeah,
there's
no way we're gonna.
I mean, Weasel is good, but he is. You can't even compare them.
There's a bunch of pieces that like if they were Transformers and they all blended together, they could turn into
a Fast Voltron in one.
Yeah, if they Voltron. they would. Turn into a Fast Forces Scarlet Witch.
Mm-hmm.
It's like they took the Fast Forces Scarlet Witch and just smashed it with a hammer. It's like, okay, we'll take this piece and put it in Weasel. We'll take this piece and put it in whoever else, Harley Quinn and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
The closest thing, honestly, to her is probably Destiny.
Destiny. I'll be honest. Destiny, if her trait did penetrating damage to normal damage, she'd be...
Easily
one of the best meta pieces around.
Yeah, she would be the next.
The fact that her damage can be reduced from that trait is a little, or is it a trait?
It's
with everybody within 6 squares.
Yeah, it's a trait.
Yeah, it's a trait. Yeah, but I mean, everybody that ability could have really made her just over the top amazing. But I mean, even still, she's still. I'm not saying she's not playable, but she doesn't bring TK to the table, which we miss in support pieces. She doesn't bring. She does bring Perplex, and she does bring her. Or she does bring Prob to it, and she hoses your opponents, outwits Perplexes and Prob. So that's decent. I mean, we're happy with that piece. As far as 50 points go, but you're realistically the heyday of the small piece is probably past. And I'll be honest, it probably is for the better in the long run. I mean, the last set I can remember that I absolutely hate playing against, which had really weird, incredibly long dials and incredibly low point pieces, was Halo pieces. Yeah. A lot of those weird things had like 9 clicks, and you're just like, I just hit this guy for 8, and he's still standing, and nobody does that anymore.
Yeah.
And he was like 48 points or something. It wasn't that bad, but it was absolutely ridiculous how just incredibly long the dials were on some of the old pieces, you know?
Yeah, but still, I don't know.
You miss it.
I mean, and that leads us to our question. Do you miss those days? Do you remember those days? Or is that, you know, I mean, think about how awesome it would have been to run 10 pieces on a team.
Yeah.
That was almost a normal back.
Oi, Yobo. Iron Pharaoh. Desu. Raven, what's this about, man?
Don't worry, man. Just keep going. They emailed us the script. We just got to follow the script. Just keep going.
Okay. Song C. Iron Pharaoh. Dude, what is this about?
Don't worry, man. They're just going to pay us a lot of money for this, dude. It's good publicity.
How much money?
Like 10,000 yen or something like that. I don't know.
Yen?
Or rupees or something. I don't know, dude. It's 10,000 something, dude.
Soshirete! Soshirete! Hombre, Pharaoh. Muy caliente, Tony Stark.
Guys, what are we?
Ooh, Cece, Poppy.
What are we doing? We got a podcast. We got a deadline.
Super Poppy.
I don't know what after us. In here.
Just slap him. Just slap him.
Huzzah! I forgot it.
That brings us our question to you. Do you think that the forces should be bigger, like they are? The points should be good. Or do you enjoy the smaller point teams? Have you even had a chance?
In recent memory, yeah.
To deal with the smaller point teams. I, for one, really want my army back. I want a whole shield army back.
You want 9 or 10 figures for 300 points,
I mean, that'd be awesome. One energy explosion.
One
kills
energy
that
kills them all.
Wipes the floor with them.
But anyway, so once again, we'd like to ask everybody who watches the video, if you have any ideas for shows you'd like us to talk about, any topics you'd like us to bring up, please let us know in the comments below. And as always, thank you for watching.